In this blog, we will see the PDF viewer implementation in your Flutter application. So sometimes we require to view a PDF file on our app. So instead of using a third-party application, we can implement the PDF viewer in our application itself. So again, here there are two conditions. So if you want to load a PDF from a local folder or from a URL, that is a URL link coming from your API. So here we will see these two kinds of implementations in this part of tutorial, and here you can see the output. This is how our implementation will appear to be. So here we have specified two buttons, that is from loading the PDF file from assets and loading from the URL here. So when you tap on load from assets, then the PDF file from the assets is being loaded. And now when you tap on from URL, then a PDF file from the URL is being loaded onto our application here. So this is a sample file which we have loaded. And so now let us see what are the things we require to start this implementation. So here we are adding a dev dependency flutter underscore plugin underscore PDF viewer. So here the current version is 1.0.7, and here you can also see we have provided a local PDF file here, sample.pdf. So you can specify your own PDF files to the assets folder according to your directory name. And now let us dive into the implementation details. So here we are considering the default class MyApp and initializing with void main. We are extending the MyApp class to a stateful widget here. So here, if you are having any queries regarding a stateful and stateless widget, do let me know in the comment section below. And also you can refer to the previous tutorials for more information on it. So we are creating a state for MyApp here. And here we have declared two variables, boolean and PDF document. So we will be providing a loading progress bar till our PDF file is loaded, and once the PDF file is loaded, we will remove progress bar. So here, this is a PDF document which we got through our dependency and using which we will be populating the PDF file onto the screen here. So now in the init state, we are initializing the load document here. So whenever you open the application, in the first screen itself we are trying to load the PDF file which is from local asset folder. So if you don't want it to be loaded, you can just skip this method. You can just skip this method and you can load the file on a button click. So just to make the file load on an app startup, so I have provided it in the init state itself. And here you can see we are fetching the file from the assets folder which we have declared in pubspec.yaml. So that is an important step. You need to specify every file you use in your application in pubspec.yaml. So if you have not specified there, then you cannot use it in your coding here. So here this method will select either the way of loading your document into your PDF viewer. So the either ways are like loading from assets and URL. So now let us see on the button tab, we will be calling those methods here. Here we have specified a sample design like you have seen in the initial view. So like we have provided two buttons, and so for which we have considered the material app which provides us the design aspects for our application. And here the scaffold will provide a structure to our application here. As a Flutter is a set of widgets, so one over the another. So over the material app we are considering a scaffold inside which we have provided an app bar here. So just to provide a title to our application, the most common thing we use in every application. And again in the body we have considered a container. So for to provide these two buttons and also the PDF viewer here. So here you can see we have also provided a PDF viewer inside our body itself. So there is no a separate screen for the PDF document to be loaded. We are making everything in a single screen. So if you want to load, if you want to move to the another screen and provide your PDF document over there, you can just move to the another screen, and in the body you can provide this PDF over there directly. So here I want to load in the same page, so I have specified it inside a container by providing a specific height, and here width is, it is wrapping the space available over the screen here. So here when you tap on the first button, so that is load from assets. So here you can see the output, you get more clarity. So when you tap on the first button, it will load it. It will call the change PDF method, inside which it will pass the value 1. So the if condition is satisfied for the first condition and the file is being loaded into our PDF document. In the same way, when you try to pass the another value, that is change PDF 2, then it will be going into the else condition here, and from which it is loading the PDF file from the URL. And you can provide different values here, as we are dealing with only two ways of loading PDF documents. So I have been using these kinds of implementation. And here, this is below the view is for the PDF viewer. And if you are having multiple pages in your PDF file, so here you can tap on this particular button at the center, which will provide you through a list of pages available in your document, and you can scroll to the page you want to be loaded and page will be directly loaded. As this in the tutorial we have used a simple PDF file, so we are having only two pages in our document. And also if you want to move to the pages, here you can use these below arrows also. So this is how a PDF implementation can be made in your Flutter application. I hope this is simple for you to understand, and if you are still having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.